All right, I'm not sure how far we're going to get it through this one in the 10-minute YouTube clip time, but we're going to give it a shot. This is from chapter 5, number 45. It deals with a ramp that is at an angle of 30 degrees and has a massless, frictionless pulley up here. And along this pulley, there's a rope, and it is attached to a mass. M1, and another mass here that is hanging down, that is M2. And there's a number of problems that are based on this picture, but the question that I'm interested in, 545, states that M1 is equal to, I believe it means for it to be 4.0 kilograms. There's actually a typo on my book, I'm not sure if it's in yours as well, and mass 2 is equal to 5.0 kilograms. And it says that the coefficient of kinetic friction between the inclined plane and the block, that is right here at this point, is equal to 0.24. It asks to find the magnitude of the acceleration of the masses and the tension in the cord. All right. Well, what we need to do is start off by drawing a force diagram. We're going to need to know information about the forces and the acceleration of each of these things, and that would be our phone ringing. I'm just going to keep going on. The force diagram for M1.
Yeah, can I ask who's calling?
Is here. We have a particle, and...
Oh, yeah, he's a little bit busy.
Awesome. Real life getting in the way.
Yeah.
Okay, so there is obviously a... The rope here is pulling on this particular mass. So there is a force due to tension, the force of the rope on the mass 1. And we also have the weight of this, which is going down. We have the force that is normal here, and let's see, like that, there is a normal force, that's obviously quite long, that should be cut down a little bit shorter. That is the normal force, or the force of the ramp on the block. That's probably a little too small. So listen, hopefully, this is the force of the ramp on the block. And there is, are there any more forces? Nope, I don't think so. There may be, you know, acceleration. This block might normally feel an acceleration down the ramp, but there certainly is not a force specifically along the ramp that causes that. The force is the weight. There's a component of the weight that actually is in directed down the ramp. So we don't actually draw that force on this particular diagram. We then know something about this. We know that there's two components to this weight force. One that is along in these two different directions here. So we know that the angle here, I should be more careful here. So this is my force diagram. I do know something about this weight, right? So the force diagram for M1 just looks like this. The force diagram for M2 is going to be simply the weight and the tension. Oops. This is the force of the rope on M2. Okay, and that's pushing up. Okay. So we have those in place, and it's important to note that the tension here is, we have a rope that is connected along this thing, that if there was, for some reason, if there happened to be more force in this piece of rope here than there was over on this piece of rope here, then you would have some acceleration of this rope. That would be consistent with a rope breaking or something like that. So we need to be careful that the way we labeled this, the force of the rope on M1 and the force of the rope here on M2 are actually going to be equal to one another. So the force within the rope is equal, in magnitude at least. So I'm going to try to make that clear here. I made my notation, my what I chose to call things isn't really helpful. But then the we can determine a lot about our force diagram here by the normal force here, the force of the ramp on the block is equal to cosine of theta times the weight, which is mass times gravity. A lot of these things we've kind of talked about previously, so I'm going to skip through a couple of steps. And there is also the that's the normal force, which is because we know that because it's equivalent to the y component, the vertical component of the weight, and we know that there's no acceleration along a direction that is vertical, vertically perpendicular to the surface. We also know that for a direction along the the sum of the forces along the edge of this thing, we know that the net force along, we could call this the an x direction, at least along, where the x direction is along the along a path that's parallel to the ramp. All right, we know that the net force in that direction is going to be equal to a this force of the rope on mass one, we can call that positive, minus the x component of the weight. All right, the x component of the weight, we can draw the force of the weight here in the x direction, which that will be equal to sine of theta times mass times gravity. And that is going to be equal to its acceleration of this. This is block one along the x direction. Okay? The force diagram for the second one here, we have the weight in a similar pattern. We don't have any forces acting on the second block along the x along an x direction that is, you know, is horizontal to the ground, but there is some in the vertical direction. So let's just call this the net forces for mass 2 along the y are going to be equal to the force of the rope on mass 2 up minus the weight, which is mass times gravity, is going to be equal to the mass 1. This is mass 2 times the acceleration of 2. Okay? So I'm going to stop this now and start this maybe in a little bit.